We're continuing with solutions to the intermediate algebra practice problems for midterm 1, and we're on number 4. 5x over 4x squared minus 9 plus 7 all over 10x plus 15. So we're adding fractions, and in order to add fractions, you have to have a common denominator, but we have two different denominators. So to find the least common denominator, let's factor each denominator. So for the first fraction, 5x over, well, let's factor 4x squared minus 9. That's a difference of two squares. 2x plus 3 times 2x minus 3. And I'm going to leave a little space here in case I need to multiply the numerator and denominator by something. I'll leave a little space just in case. Plus, and I've got 7 over, now if I factor 10x plus 15, let's see, I could take out a common factor of 5, and that's 2x plus 3. And I'll leave some space in case I need to multiply that by something. So looking at the denominators, you see I'm going to need from this first fraction a 2x plus 3 and a 2x minus 3, but I'll also need a factor of 5. So I need to multiply the first fraction by 5 over 5, and now what you see in this denominator will be the least common denominator. I need to have the same factors for the second fraction, so I'm missing the 2x minus 3. So I need to multiply the numerator and denominator here by 2x minus 3. So now we need to multiply 5x times 5 for the first numerator, and that'll give you 25x. And since it's all going to be over the common denominator, I'm just going to put plus. And I'm going to do the same thing for the second fraction. Notice I have 7 times 2x minus 3. So let's go ahead and do the distributive property here. We'll end up having to multiply 7 times 2x plus 3, and that'll give you 14x minus 21. And that'll all be over the denominator. Since I have a common denominator, you just need to write it once. So I have 5 times 2x plus 3 times 2x minus 3. All right, our next step would be to simplify the numerator so we can combine like terms here. So we've got 25x plus 14x will give us 39x plus 21 all over 5 times 2x plus 3 times 2x minus 3. Now, at this point, you want to see if it's possible to cancel any further. And so what I'm going to do is factor the numerator, if I can, to see if anything will cancel. So out of the numerator, 39x plus 21, I can factor out a 3, and that would give you 13x plus 7, but none of these factors would cancel with anything in the denominator. So I could leave the answer like that, 5 times 2x plus 3 times 2x minus 3. Whoops. Or I could leave my answer in this form. You could also multiply out the denominator if you'd like. In other words, if you want to write the 2x plus 3 times 2x minus 3 as 4x squared minus 9, you can do that. You could leave the denominator like that, or you could keep going and say 20x squared minus 45 for the denominator. So you've got a variety of ways to write to writing your final answer. All right, on to number 5. Again, we're subtracting fractions, so you need to have a common denominator. So let's begin by factoring each denominator. So the first fraction, 2x minus 3, let's see, how's this factor? It's going to be x and x, 3 and 4, minus and minus. Again, you can factor on your own scratch paper, lots of different ways people use to factor, minus, and this denominator, x minus 3, can't be factored any further, so I'm just going to write x minus 3. So basically, the least common denominator is going to be x minus 3 times x minus 4, because x minus 3 is already in this one. So I just need to multiply the second fraction by x minus 4 over x minus 4, and now they have the same denominator. Now here's where you have to be very careful. You're subtracting this entire fraction up on top. So there's two ways you could deal with this. You could put minus 2 parentheses x minus 4, and remember to distribute the minus sign, so it's going to be negative 2 times x minus 4, or you could multiply 2 times x minus 4 and then distribute the minus sign all the way through. Right, so I'm going to do it this way. 2x plus 3 minus 2x minus 4. That's how I'm going to write the new numerator, because you're subtracting 2 times that all over. Oops, that's x minus. It's always important to copy your problems correctly. And now, you cannot cancel this x minus 4 with this x minus 4. Remember, the whole idea was to multiply this numerator by something so you could subtract. So we have 2x plus 3, and I'm going to distribute the minus 2. So it's a negative 2x and a plus 8. That's where most people make their mistakes. They'll write minus 8. So be careful of the minus signs. And that will all be over the denominator, x minus 3 times x minus 4. So what do I end up with here? Well, I'm going to combine like terms up at the top, and I have a 2x minus 2x, so that's gone, 0. So 3 plus 8 is 11 over x minus 3 times x minus 4. And nothing cancels. First of all, 11's prime. And so there we go. Here's number 6. 2 fifths minus 4 over 3x all over 7 over 15x minus 2. This is a complex fraction. First of all, it looks complex, doesn't it? But basically, if you have a fraction where there's at least one fraction in the numerator or denominator, you've got a complex fraction. So to simplify a complex fraction, one method is to find the least common denominator of all the denominators. So I have a denominator of 5, 3x, and 15x. 15x is the least common denominator. Once you find that, you multiply the whole numerator by the least common denominator and the whole denominator by the least common denominator. So you're multiplying by 15x over 15x. Now, the reason this method works is because if that's the least common denominator, each denominator will cancel into that, and we will be left with something that is not a complex fraction. So that's our next step. We need to distribute that 15x to all the terms in the parentheses in this case. So we've got 15x times 2 fifths minus 15x times 4 over 3x all over 15x times 7 over 15x minus 15x times 2. Now notice 2 is not a fraction, so nothing's going to cancel when I do the 15x times 2, because there was no fraction there to begin with. Alright, so now we get to do the fun canceling. Let's see, 5 goes into 15 3 times, so what I really have is 3 times x times 2. 3 times x times 2 is 6x. And I have minus, let's see what happens here. The x's both cancel, right? And the 3 goes into the 15 5 times, so I really have 5 times 4. 20. All right, going down to the denominator, the 15x cancels with 15x, so I just have 7. And then I got 15x times 2, which is 30x. All right, so that's what I'm going to have here. Let's see, it's a little smaller. And can you factor? You can factor the numerator. You could take a 2 out, and you have 3x minus 10, but that's not going to cancel anyway, so it's perfectly fine to leave your answer like this. There's more than one way to write this. You might rewrite the 7 minus 30x is negative 30x plus 7, for instance. Okay, so go on to the next video and we'll start with number 7.